mixed world. You can see pictures of Michael Jackson, you can see pictures of Japanese guy on the top of a roof in Brooklyn. You can see pictures of beautiful people, kids. I'm DELPHINE DIALLO, photographer and visual artist. This is the show that I did at the Rush Art Gallery with the Danny Simons Gallery, and it was created by Hank Willis Thomas. This is Indy, another project called The Golden Child. Indy is one of them. She has already a lot of wisdom, 11 years old, and she actually look at you, look at me, and she can see the future. So I'm trying to define what you can see. I shot the picture and then the collage all around, it's really the motion of what she's supposed to have in her brain at the moment. So it's going through through a lot of like kid stuff. That's why I'm shooting myself also with kids. And then all this world of fashion and beauty around her. Because of course she wants to become beautiful. And kids picture most often, little stars, Elizabeth Taylor, everybody wants to become glamorous and successful. It's a collaboration, the first one that I did with Cidi. This guy is just collaging all this model, mannequin, and then he's selling on the street on Queen Street. And what I asked him to do on this project, it's actually to collage a real woman. This one's called Empire Illusion. And it's pretty much the influence of the media on her body. Information, everything that we receive it, that's what we become. So Empire Illusion is that kind of experience of saying, we are what we see. We are what we need. This is a Peter Beard, very famous photographer, who actually gave me those pictures. I was from the 1970s and 80s. And here we go. This is in Africa, in Botswana. I'm on the top of an elephant. He shot beautiful pictures and then he put me on the top of the elephant. The story that I did in Montana. When I moved in New York and in America, I was trying to define a new way to see America. And the way that I'm seeing America is very movie-wise. So I have a vision of America, it was very from the movies. So I've been in the middle of Montana to see how things there are. Pretty much American white people, they will be spending a lot of time with Native American. And that's why I shot that.
How did they take you? They were really cool.
Well, they take me. It's like, where are you from? Are you from Paris, France? This is so far away. You're welcome here. You can take any picture. That's fine. So they were really nice to me because I was the only black woman. The Crow tribe is this tribe that Obama has been adopted. It's one of the biggest tribes in the country. They're still speaking the language, Absaloka language. And Obama get adopted from them because he really helped the Crow tribe to get more money to be able to support, you know, to support the industry, the way that they're working and the way that they treat the land. It's me! So Avatar. Avatar is very interesting because first self-portrait, arriving in America and try to understand the culture and say, if I'm doing a self-portrait, what is it supposed to be? It's supposed to be a vision of yourself who's a perfection, but you just don't want to be just fashion posing model. So what I did when I saw Avatar, it was really interesting and I say, it's fantastic. A picture where I don't look black or white, and I look like a blue person. It's fantastic. So when I did Avatar, it was a critique about the way that people see you while you're black or white, and how people will see me if I'm an avatar. So it was making sense to me to just do Avatar, then people can relate to the hybrid mixed world. Up in the morning, they're already on working on cars.
Wow.
And I really have a lot of respect for them, so this is the people that I want to be shot with and remember when I'm gonna get older.
Mm.
You know?